Good morning, everyone. It is March 20th, 2020. This is your daily video. Hope everyone had a fantastic weekend. I hope that all your virtual learning is going fantastic and that you are taking care of all of your business. This is the last week before we have our spring break. So for our class, we are going to wrap up the Ancient Rome unit before we move forward. All right, with that being said, our lesson today is going to be on the last Romans. Now, I'm going to start by giving you what your assignment is, because I'd like you to know that before you watch the remainder of this video. Your assignment at the end of this is going to be to write one paragraph on who you think the last Romans were. And I'll elaborate on that, because it's not one group and it's not one person. We're talking more metaphorically, and what that means is like a representation. I'll talk about a couple different groups and then, you know, pose some questions for you to think about. So when you do your assignment, know that whatever you choose is not wrong, and as long as you explain why you think that, you're going to get full credit on it, all right? So it's really meant for you to think about it and kind of, you know, tell me what you think or who you think were the last Romans. Also with that, this is a dual purpose lesson, right? Yes, I'm going to talk about these groups and some of these people who were, you know, technically considered the last Romans, but it also, I'm going to give you some insight into how the final days and final years were. So I'm going to fill you in with a little bit of background information as well. All right, with that being said, let's do it up. All right, so would you consider the last Romans their last leaders, the last couple emperors that they had? That would make sense, right? The last official emperor that they had was Romulus Augustus, who was super, super young. And he was more of a figurehead than anything else. He had like a general behind him who was, you know, calling all the shots, making all the decisions. There was also Julius Nepos. He's one of the last emperors. Both really didn't contribute that much to ancient Rome as a society. You know, this was a tail end, so not a lot of big things were really happening other than barbarians coming in and taking over. One note that I want to tell you is that, the Ottoman Sultan Mehmed VI, when he took over Constantinople, they attacked Constantinople, they you know, wipe it out. He and his ancestors took on the name Caesars because they loved ancient Rome and it was so prestigious. Do you consider them, you know, last Romans? I wouldn't think so. Let's move forward. All right, the next group are the Republicans. All right, so remember, Rome had a very advanced government at the time where they had a representative democracy. You voted people into office. They voted to make decisions. Hold on. You elected people into office. They voted to make decisions, and they ran it that way. So they had debates and discussed things and did what was best or what they thought was best for people by voting on laws and whatnot. But the Republican era ended with the death of Julius Caesar. That's when we see emperors really starting to take over. So do you consider the last official Romans, you know, when Caesar died? You know, did they do enough before emperors took over to save Rome, or was the fall of Rome attributed to the death of Caesar and the end of the Republic as we know it? Let's move on to the next one. Do you consider the generals the last Romans? So remember, at this time, we have barbarians attacking. Barbarians, once again, are anybody who isn't born in Rome, who lives outside of Rome and come in and, you know, they're attacking all over the place. You have Roman civil wars. Rome is fighting itself. There's no funding whatsoever. So do you consider them the last real Romans? You know, they're fighting with the purpose of saving this empire that they've had, you know, which means they care about it. They want it to flourish. They want it to do well. So are they the last of the Romans? There's two Roman generals I want to talk to you about. One's name is Flavius Stilicho. The other one's name is Flavius Attalus. Yes, they both have the same first name. And historians, you know, will tell you that the Roman Empire lasted longer because there were these two generals who were just awesome and did absolutely everything they could in battle, and you know, to win different battles and wars, different, you know, things going on, and kept Rome around for longer. Could be a reason why you might consider them, you know, the last real Romans. All right, we'll move on to the next one. All right, the restorers. So somebody who restores something, you might see like TV shows and stuff about restorations. You know, people who restore things, take older things and try to rebuild them into something new. We know that the East fell before the West, and there were people in the East who still tried to rebuild Rome in the East so that it could once again live up to what it was. The main person here that you should know is Emperor Justinian I. And after Rome fell, Eastern Rome fell, he takes two generals who were also fantastic, and he goes out on these adventures, and he tries to take back some of the land that they lost. And they actually do take back Africa, they take back parts of Spain, and they take back Italy after being conquered. So, you know, he does a good job. Don't think that just because Eastern Rome fell, that Western Rome was the only part of Rome that was left. And while Western Rome was still trying, you know, to survive, Eastern Rome was thriving a little bit, really until the death of Justinian, and then it kind of all fell apart. But, you know, are they the ones still fighting for this belief of, you know, ancient Rome and what it was? Would you consider them the last Romans? All right, next one. The last defenders. Or do you consider the last defenders the people who are really fighting when Constantinople falls to the Ottoman Empire? Remember, Constantinople was the capital of Western Rome at the time. So you have people in the army fighting till the absolute end. Constantine the 11th is the emperor here, and he, along with his generals, they're fighting till they absolutely cannot fight anymore. Do you consider them the last Romans? So your assignment, once again, when you do this, right, there's no wrong answer. Explain your side of the story, though. So you need to meet the requirements of 4-plus sentences. It's one paragraph. 4-plus sentences, so 4 or more. And tell me, I believe that this group were the last Romans because, and then keep it going. Give me some examples of why you think that. And that's it for today. We will have some sort of like project type thing that we'll do later in this week. And we'll wrap up ancient Rome. So I hope your Monday is fantastic and you have a good day.